And in WWALS County, we've got 100 new residents after Hurricane Irma. We call them halfbacks. What's that mean? They moved to Florida under a hurricane, so they're halfway back. They didn't move back because of lack of toll roads. They got out. They moved out because of lack of infrastructure. Okay, what do I hear from WWALS County, Georgia? I'm the Suwannee Riverkeeper. I and all our members care about fishable, drinkable, smokable water in the entire 10,000 square miles of the Suwannee River Basin from Ipanoga Swamp, Fort Yale, Georgia, all the way down to the Gulf. Okay, so what would actually keep halfbacks from leaving the state? Well, for example, some of the people I know in this room are usually without power for a week or two after a hurricane. It's not because they don't have electric lines running to their houses. What would help that? Solar power batteries for a fraction of what's being proposed to be spent on these roads. You can fix that problem. Similarly, broadband. In rural communities, you're not going to run fiber optic to every house. There's no one can afford that. It's going to be wireless. You can put up wireless towers for way less than the cost of this road. What else do we need? Water quality testing. Some of you may have heard about Boston, a sewage problem. I said, I do not now, nor have I ever lived in the city of Boston. We need water quality testing frequently, at least once a week, up and down the rivers. I bet you could do that for a year if the lesson has already been spent on these meetings. Now, I hasten to add, I compliment all of you who are sitting on the task force doing this work, but you are the cart before the horse. No one has established the need for this road. That should have been done before any of these meetings, before anybody asks you to spend your time sitting there for hour after hour. Oh, what else could we use? We could use less water withdrawals, including by Nestle selling it back to us in plastic bottles that we don't have to pick up out of our rivers and streams. And we could use a little change in agriculture. I'm a farmer myself, but I use a third as much fertilizer as is common in the Suwannee River Basin. It can be done. There's lots of problems that could be addressed. A toll road addresses none of them. Suwannee Riverkeeper is also a member of the No Build Movement Coalition. And it doesn't really matter if you have a no build option formally or not. It's kind of like jury confirmation. You can choose to say, don't build that road. Thank you.